My job, as you can see, I work for the security here in Sweden. We call it on the word for fartygsvärd.
Okay.
That's a Swedish word for this. That's meaning mostly that we say take care of our guests, look that they have a good, nice travel from Karlskrona to Gdynia and back. But sometimes people have party, they're drinking, sometimes they get too much. And then we go in there and take them away from the place. Yes, and take them down to the cabin if everything is nice with them, so that we can speak with them. But we meet all people who's a little aggressive sometimes, but not so often. That's most in the weekend. We can have people who don't have an extra big party. And then we come to this place here, so it's not so nice. But that's the lastest way we go. That's the people who's very aggressive, don't listen to what we tell them and what our rules is on board. Then we must take them up here. But for the most of the things, we go around in the ship. We can look for the people, that everything is good. Help them, if somebody gets sick, we are the first help here on board before we contact the bridge. And we help them with luggage, with everything, to find back to the cabin. Yeah, we do the most for this to be happy. We have, you can tell we have the stories from the oldest woman who gets sick on the board with a heart attack, and we are helping her back in the life. We have also people who have gone so long to take the life from other guests. But that's not happened often. I have been in 20 years, I have that one time. I think we have it two times in the whole time we have traveled with this boat. That can happen. And yes, we must be prepared for everything. We live up in Kål, city there, so called Herjuna. It's between Alingsås and Borås.
Okay.
And I have a long way to the work, yeah. But yes. Since I work with some other things here on board too, then it's like that, that I travel with one friend every time or two. I'm driving together. So I drive the car and I pick up two other. It was an old man, he was very, very nervous. He came to me at night and he asked if he can talk to somebody, and I said, oh, sure, you can. You can sit down and speak a little bit. And he said to me, you see, I'm so afraid, he said, because my wife was in an accident, a car accident. So she's sitting alone in a wheelchair. And I'm not sure that she can make that self when she are at home. And I said, yeah, but what have your wife said when you travel here? You have speak to her before you travel. Yes, he said, now you can go out. I fixed that stuff. But he was still very nervous because he had sitting in this in 5 years and he had not leaving the house at home for 5 years. About. He had only take care of his wife. And the day goes and the night comes, we see him speak, I think totally first a half an hour, then it was a 1 hour, and then I said, call your wife. And she said, everything is good. Hope you have it nice too. But when the man come home from this trip and speak with the wife, he was a different person. When he had get my telephone number, and the wife said, what person you have to speak with? Was it a psychologist or something like that? And he said, no, he was only one of the guys on the boat. And they have invited me up to Dalsland. And that was very interesting, because when I come up there, the wife said, after this, he have turned around, so now for first time for 5 years he have let me do things what I every time want to do. But every time I want to go up, every time I want to do something, he was there for helping me. So everything was locked in this relationship between them. So that was a very nice history. So I will visit them 2 times after that one. No? Today she's out from this and she's normal again. No? So that was very nice. And some people, a thing like that, you remember very much.